as we are getting ready now for the first ball to be thrown out, Yogi has come on the field with the umpires. And I think we can give you the lineups as we have them now. For the Red Sox, it'll be Chuck Schilling leading off, playing second base. Yes, the two will be a short hitting second. Kyle Yastrzemski, the American League leading hitter last year, playing left field, hitting third. Frank Maljone in the cleanup spot, playing third base. Dick Stewart at first base, hitting fifth. Lou Clinton will be in right field, hitting sixth. Tony Conigliaro, second-year player, had a great year in Wellsville in a Class A league last year. He's starting off in center field for the Red Sox today. Bob Tillman will do the catching and hit eighth. And Bill Mondelkett, a 20-game winner for the Red Sox last year, will do the pitching. For the Yankees, it'll be Phil Lynch leading off, playing shortstop in the place of the injured Tony Kubek. Bobby Richardson will be at second, hitting second. Roger Maris will be in right field in the third spot. Mickey Mantle in the cleanup spot in center field. Donnie Kress will be in left, hitting fifth. Joe Pepitone will be the first baseman, hitting in the sixth spot. Ellie Howard will do the catching, he'll hit seventh. Cleet Boyer at third, hitting eighth. And Whitey Ford, a 24-game winner for the Yankees last year, will be doing the pitching. And this will represent Whitey's ninth opening day assignment for the Yankees. While the two managers, Yogi Berra and Johnny Pesci, are at the home plate area talking over the ground rules with the umpires, we'll give the umpires Ed Hurley behind the plate, John Flaherty at first, Bill Haller at second, and Sam Carrigan at third. It's my distinct pleasure to say hello once again and to bring on one of my favorite people, the old redhead who's fit as a fiddle and raring to go. And I know that you're happy to be back and on the ball again, Ed.
Thank you, Jerry. Thank you, Jerry, very, very much. And looking down at the field, this must be quite a moment for Yogi, isn't it?
Well, it has to be, Red. I can't imagine that it's any different for him today. His first assignment as a manager, and it might have been the first game to play in the Yankee Stadium. I'm sure there are a few butterflies going, but it's part of it, and it kind of helps you think a little bit.
Well, of course, he was managing all spring, but when you start managing for the Marlins, it's different.
Oh, boy. It's just like many times you have a great spring hitting. It doesn't mean much to you until that bell starts ringing, because those are the ones that count, and those are the games that you put on the record books in one way or the other.
Well, it's good to be back with you and with Mel and Phil. And it's a short dog. Okay, all right. And we'll go to work. The umpires have started out across the field. As Jerry told you, we've had all the opening day preliminaries. Whitey Ford has the big assignment. Now for the Red Sox, Chuck Schilling, second baseman, then shortstop Eddie Boutreau, followed by Carl Yastrzemski. Chuck Schilling, slender right-hand batter. Ed Hurley, ball and strike umpire. Ford makes his first pitch, and it's grounded down to short in the hole. Lins will throw over to first in time, left two-step, and Schilling is out. One pitch. Very fine shortstop last year. Red Sox has got a young rookie. We'll tell you about him. We'll get to him. Tony Conigliaro. Coach Billy Herman says he came to swing that bat. Now, there's the two. Tall right-hand batter taking the serve for a strike. The defense is not too deep. Step around for the up.
Traffic conditions cause more of this damaging sludge than ever before. More than ordinary motor oil can cope with. But now, you can combat engine sludge with new Atlantic Imperial motor oil. It keeps more dirt in suspension, helps keep sludge off engine parts, drains out deposits with each oil change. Some of the new highly publicized motor oils you've heard about may claim to perform miracles, yet none of them can protect your engine better. Prove it to yourself with a special introductory offer on new Atlantic Imperial motor oil. The first oil so good, Atlantic has given it the Imperial name and feel.
Opening day at the stadium, or that it was originally scheduled for Tuesday. Weather got it. Weather got again yesterday, where it was moved into what was an open day. And so today was scheduled to be the second game of the season. But it is opening day. And the game that was scheduled originally for today is going to be made up as part of a 29th double cutter from the Red Sox of York Tuesday evening, June 16th. So you can put that down. Well, Bill Monbiket last year won 20 ball games for the Red Sox, and he was the first caller in 10 years to do that. The Boston, he is the opening day pitcher. Bob Stillman is back to the plate. First baseman is Dick Stewart. Second baseman is Chuck Schilling. Shortstop is Eddie Pizzou. And the third baseman is our old friend who was born and grew up here in the Bronx, Frank Maldon. Out in left field, the new batting champion. The center fielder is the rookie that we want to tell you about when we get down the center. Tony Conigliaro. And out in right field is a political weekly center. The Yankees will be leading off with Lynn, then Richardson, and then Tamara. Going on in Ralph's mind. This this disease in street clothes, of course. This is the first time that he's been in street clothes for the opening of a baseball season in years and years, except for when he was in the Army. All right, two balls, one strike. All right, this lead, Mamba got 50, then Mallow swings it. Conigliaro on it. Makes the catch for the third out. No runs, one hit on the score at the end of one inning. The Red Sox nothing and the Yankees nothing.
Tickets for all 1964 Yankee home games are on sale now. Here are several simple ways to get your choice of seats for the big games this season. You can buy tickets over the counter at the Yankee Stadium Advance Ticket Office, open daily Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and on Sunday from 10 a.m. until 5 p.m. until after the completion of all night games. There's plenty of free parking while you do your quick ticket shopping. Tickets are also on sale at the Yankees' convenient Midtown Ticket Office on the mezzanine of the Grand Central Terminal overlooking the main information booth. The Grand Central Ticket Office is open Monday through Friday from 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. and from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. on Saturday. Box and reserve seat reservations are also available at all Schraff restaurants in the greater New York area. And, of course, you can order now by mail. Simply send your order to the ticket manager, New York Yankees, Yankee Stadium, Bronx 51, New York. Close your check or money order to cover and include your own name and address. Box seats are $350 and reserve seats are still $250, all tax included. Please add a quarter to your total order to cover the mailing charges.
Now we move along. Inning two. No score. Frank Malzone. Dick Stewart, Lou Clinton. First three hitters to face Mighty Four. Four delivers, and it's a fair low inside to Malzone. Has his orders, but the pesky wants him to take another one. There's a ground ball that's hit hit of the year, and the Red Sox now have a threat going. With men at first and third, nobody out, and the batter is Lou Clinton. Clinton is the fellow who 2 years ago had that fantastic finish, and then last year he sort of tailed off. Right-handed batter, the Yankees have the infield under Yogi's direction and double play depth. The outfield is slightly around toward left. There's no score, but the Red Sox are threatening. Ford delivers, and Clinton swinging out back. Strike one.
Running with two outs, Conigliaro made it all the way around. The
20-10 in the league and was 4-1 against New York. 2-0 favor Boston. Being played around to a third to come up with a double play and almost a triple play. We might have had a base hit. And then we have two little pot flies fall inside the right field foul line. This is low outside ball three. 3-1. Yogi hasn't been pacing. He's just been leaning on the post. Outside and it is ball four. And Juan Luis Castro to make that ball. Whitey started the second inning with a walk. He's now gone. Now this pushes Tillman down to second base. And we have Chuck Killing coming up for his second at bat. He opened the ball game. Grounding out, start to first. Go back to what we were saying about changing the state law on the starting times of athletic events on Sunday. The Yankees are now going to be able to have all of their Sunday games start at 1:30. There's a high fly ball to left field. Stretches back at the edge of the track. Here almost to the stand when one hands it. Filling almost put it away.
Pleasure when everything is right. A fully charged battery. A motor that's smooth and powerful. Everything for a perfect drive. You've just stopped and filled the tank with gasoline, and you're out on the highway again. What's the matter?
He didn't clean the windshield.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Now I have to clean it myself, but doggone it, this is annoying.
Yes, a dirty windshield is annoying, but it'll always be cleaned when you drive into an Atlantic station that displays the Red Ball sign. Atlantic Red Ball dealers guarantee to offer to clean your windshield and check your oil every time, weather permitting, or your gasoline purchase is free. Look for the Red Ball sign of guaranteed service. Although this offer may vary in some states, Atlantic Red Ball service never varies.
Cat getting ready to pitch the Yankees with a 2-0 lead. Last half the second inning, he'll be facing Trash, Capitone, and Howard. The Yankees move down to Baltimore, and then they go to Boston, and they will be back home for a later day, Saturday afternoon, on the 25th. And Sunday, and remember that'll be 1:30, the 26th. White Sox are in the 28-29. The Boston right-handed pitcher swung on with a high fly ball deep to right center field. Conigliaro going back. And right up against the wall, where it's gone 407 feet. That's quite a play for the rookie. Well, you handle that one. On it, hit it right to the wall and right center. 407 feet away. Now we have Joel Capitone. Pinch around foot right on Joel, left hand hitter. Pitch low, curveball, ball one. It's a funny game. You can just hit one like that and have it caught, and you can have a pop fly drop in for a base hit for the man on. One out, nobody on. Nothing Boston. Right-hander delivers and cuts short. It's a high foul. Got the children coming back. I think he has room. He has. He turned it. He takes it.
ball one. As everyone knows, Howard has the ability to hit the right center and the right and the power.
Imperial Motor Oil. We're so sure Imperial Motor Oil can better protect your engine that we make this special introductory offer good till May 15th. Change now to new Atlantic Imperial Motor Oil and get your ad-free card. Then if you need a quart of oil within 30 days of that change, Atlantic will add that quart free.
Now we're moving to inning three. Red Sox leading 2-0 and Whitey Ford pitching to Eddie Versu. On a curve, not only misses, but falls down. He unbuttoned his shirt on that one. Way Ford, who had a tough inning last time out, delivers, and there is a line drive. Third and shortstop. Knocked the line drive down just about ankle high. Couldn't hold it. And by the time he recovered and threw the first, the two was on the bag, and it is a base hit for the Red Sox shortstop. Single to third. Boyer came close to making one of his spectacular stops. Now we have four hits for the Red Sox. And the batter is Carl Yastrzemski, who swings, hits a trickler to forward field, goes to first base with it, and Yastrzemski is out. The runner moving to second base. It's Frank Malzahn, who began that two-run second inning with a base on balls. Through the middle by Malzahn. But the helmet was bringing him all the way.
Stewart, who got the first Red Sox base hit, which was a clean one, in the second inning. Going back to young Pete Mickelson, he got in 10 ball games this spring, just 16 in the third inning. Pitch at the plate outside. Had a very low earned run average of 1.68. Right-hand hitter, cuts on a curve, fouls it, and it is one and one. Ball and strike. Miles on at first. And then Elmberg pushing down the hill. Now Stewart steps out. He asked for the loaded bat, which the on-deck hitters use, and he uses it to knock some dirt out of his spike. He'd rather stuff up that than stuff up his regular stick. All right, the infield double play that. Pitch went on, fouled along the right field line, and into the bag. One and two. One man out. Red Sox three, and the Yankees nothing.
Foul ball
just went, it went two people past it. Touches on it, delivers, and Ford, gloving a bunt, then takes the curve for a call strike. Outfield is not too deep, it's shortened up on Whitey. Third baseman Malzone is up on the inner grass. The rest of the infield is about halfway. Strike one pitch, Ford bluffs the bunt, takes two pitches outside. Ford was first bluffing the bunt, then he was going to hit it. And he thought it was wide and took it. So he was pretty busy. Right-hander delivers, and Ford takes a high outside ball. Up there on the scoreboard, calling attention to the next business here at the stadium. Baltimore, which will be later today, Saturday, April the 25th. So far. 26 at 1:30. Now, don't let this change of Sunday time throw you, but it's brand new. Ford delivered the curve for, takes the curve, looks like this, didn't you? You know, in the past, 2 o'clock was the earliest you could start a ball game. They changed the law, and the Sunday games at the stadium are going to be 1:30, whether they are single games or doubleheaders. Keep that in mind. I get 2 o'clock on Sunday. 2-2 pitch. One on. Pitch is going high outside. Splinter. All right, a full count to Whitey. Juan Marquette working on him carefully. Boy on at first base. The Red Sox leading 3-0. That totals are 3-5 all. The Yankee totals are 0-2 all. The pitch is taken high. Ford draws a base on ball. And this pushes Boyer down to second base. First ball given up by Hansel Kapp. And Boyer's pitch is swing high outside. Splinter. All right, a full count to Whitey. Juan Marquette working on him carefully. Boyer on at first base. The Red Sox leading 3-0. That totals are 3-5 all. The Yankee totals are 0-2 all. The pitch is taken high. Ford draws the base on ball. And this pushes Boyer down to second base. First walk given up by Hansel Kapp. And now we have the top of the order, Phil Lynn, who is opening the season for Kubek, has a cold in the muscles in his upper back. He's taking heat treatment. Delivers, and Lynn takes a ground ball to second. Still a bounce to over at second base, and that's all. He missed a double play. The ball got away from the second baseman briefly. He recovered in time for the fourth on Ford, the runner from first. But what looked to be a double play ball was lost on the bobble. There's no error, of course, as they got him out. Schiller to Brasseau. Boyer on the sequence, moving over to third base. Lynn's at first. For him is reaching there on the field of choice, and we now have Bobby Richardson. Defense is pretty well straight away. Infield double play depth with first baseman Stewart holding the bag against Lynn. One Marquette delivers, and there's a ground ball to third, and Marzullo can't pick it up. It's in the hole. It's sort of a hit. A run is called for New York, and the rally is still on. Malzone would make that play, going to his left.
Mets are leading 3-1. And we'll get pitches over for a call strike. Starting at 6 o'clock June 16 is to make up a game the schedule for today. The Yankees opening, you know, is rained out for 2 days. There's a high fly ball to deep left center field. Conigliaro going on this, makes the catch. And here is Lynn going over after the catch and the throw in to third base.
Leaping high against the wall out in deep right center. swing ground ball in the hole. Boy, it's got it one hand. Throw it to first in time for the out. A fine play by Clete Boyer. And it brings up Bob Tillman. Tillman dropped a little Texas League single in the short right field in the second inning. Red Sox have 5 hits to go with their 3 runs. The Yankees, 4 hits and 2 runs. Marty Ford working his 9th opening game here at Yankee Stadium. Hit the curve, hit up the middle of base hit. Becky Mantle in fast, up with it. The outfielders have to be on the ball today because the outfield, as we told you, is wet and slow. And ground balls hit out there stop before they get through the outfielders. And if you get some of these fast runners that hit a bouncing ball through the infield, they could possibly make a double on it if the outfielder is not ready for it. Brings up Bill Monbiquette, who walked in the second inning. Whitey flips over to first base, but Tillman was standing on the bag. Whitey stretches throw to first, but Tillman is back again. On balls have cost both pitchers in this ball game. Whitey walked 2 in the 4th inning when 2 runs scored. Monboquette walked 1 when a run scored. A butt foul at the plate. Strike 1. And strangely enough, Whitey walked Monboquette to set up a run, and Monboquette walked Whitey to set up a run for the Yankees. And there's nothing that makes a pitcher madder than walking the opposing pitcher. Boyer is way in at third. Here's the stretch. The pitch is butted foul down the third baseline. Nothing in 2 on Mambo. Boyer remains in at third, even though there are 2 strikes, no balls on Monboquette. With 1 out, he's still looking for the possible sacrifice. On deck, Chuck Schilling. Stretch by Whitey. His pitch, he squares around, bunts at it, misses strike 3. Whitey Ford chalking up his 3rd strike out of the ballgame. And it brings up Schilling, who bounced to short and flies deep to left field. Trish had a back up and catch the ball one-handed back over his head just in front of the railing in deep left field. Would have been way over the screen at Fenway Park. 2 out. The pitch to Schilling is on the outside corner. Strike 1 call. On deck, Eddie Brasseau. Again, the stretch by Whitey. His pitch hit on the ground. Lynch to his left. Up with a flip to Richardson for the 4th play. For the Red Sox in the top of the 4th inning, no runs, 1 hit, no Yankee errors, 1 man left. And at the end of 3.5, it's Boston 3, New York 2. For the Yankees, Joe Pepitone leads off. Pepitone fouled out to Bob Tillman, the catcher, in the second inning. The Red Sox 3, the Yankees 2, we're in the bottom of the 4th. Opening day for both teams here at Yankee Stadium. Bill Monboquette ready. His pitch is a slow curve in there. Strike 1 call to Pepitone. On deck, Elston Howard. Call your safety. Not too deep in left field, but they're deep in center and right field again, Pepitone. Mambo's next pitch is outside. 1-1. First year, Monboquette defeated the Yankees 4 times, losing to them only once. And Mambo won 20 games last year, losing only 10. It's 1-1 pitch, outside, ball 2-1. Pepitone has a lot of room down the left field line as Yastrzemski is skating him over in left center. Not wearing the golf club today, although he has his left wrist heavily taped. The windup, the 2-1 pitch is low inside, ball 3. Well, on opening day, we've got old leather lungs be heard all over the park. Real rabid fan. A 3-1 count on Pepitone. Nobody out, nobody on in the bottom of the fourth. Pitch to Joe is outside, ball four. That's the second walk given up by Mopo. It brings up Elston Howard. Ellie struck out in the second inning. Tillman, the catcher, out to the mound to talk with Mondo Kessler. Good to be back at Yankee Stadium. Here's the stretch. There goes Pepitone. The ball is hit in the center field. And coming on fast is dropping in for a base hit. And Pepitone must have been aware that it was going to drop in because he stood at second base. And had Luke Clinton made the play, he would have been doubled at first. But Pepitone had a better look at it than we did from up here. Off the end of the bat as Howard drops a single in the short right center field. That's the fifth hit for the Yankees. And Howard runs at first and second. Nobody out here is Pete Boyle, who lined a single at center field in the third inning. Pete Jordan and Wilbur Wood are loosening up in the bullpen for the Red Sox. The pitch, a fly ball to right field, fairly deep, going back to tag up is Pepitone. Clinton makes the catch. Pepitone easily goes to third base, holding at first is Howard. Boyer hit it far enough to right field, allowing Pepitone to tag up, easily go to third. Here's Whitey Ford. Whitey walked in the third inning. On deck, Phil Lynn. Teddy Brasseau comes in from shortstop to talk with Mon Bouquet. Tell him who's covering in case the ball is hit back to him. Also to tell him to be on the alert in the event of a possible squeeze play. Pepitone at third. Howard at first with one out. The stretch. Pitch to Whitey is just outside. Ball one. And now that Yastrzemski is really playing a shallow left field. Man, he is really in there. And Conigliaro has moved in center field. The only one playing his normal position is Lou Clinton in right field. Boy, well, they are shallow out there. Bon Boquet set. His pitch is outside. Ball two, 2-0. Eddie Brasseau has a good habit of running in back of the pitcher's box. As the catcher's tossing the ball back to the pitcher, just in the event that he might throw one wild, which does happen occasionally. Catcher just trying to lob the ball back to the pitcher. It's 2-0 on Whitey. The pitch, he bluffed the punt, takes it for a strike. Whitey was taken all the way that time. Two balls, one strike. Man, there's an old plane, a one-motor job. An old Ford tri-motor, and it looks like it's standing still right over Yankee Stadium. The stretch, the pitch to Whitey. Outside, ball three, 3-1. Well, Joe Cooper said that's the kind Admiral Byrd used when he went to the South Pole in 1927. Low but sure. A 3-1 count on Whitey. Runners lead off first and third. The pitch is taken. Ball four. And the bases are loaded. Damn, that ball just missed the outside corner. The second time that Whitey Ford has walked. And the third ball given up by Mon Bouquet. With most of the bases, Ford at first, Howard at second, Pepitone at third. And the batter is Phil Lynn, who's 0 for 2. Lynn slide to center and bounce to second base. Lynn can do a lot of things with that bat. He can bunt. He can hit and run. And he doesn't strike out too often. Besides which, he's a pretty fast runner. But he's got a lot of things going for him in this spot. The Red Sox leading 3-2 in the bottom of the fourth. Trumbo steps off the rubber, goes to the rosin bag. Bobby Richardson in the on-deck circle, swinging a couple of bats. One man out. Here's the windup. Pitch to Lins is low, ball one, and Mongo's head almost tripped as he threw the ball, and here comes Johnny Pesky out of the dugout, and Mongo yells something at Ed Hurley, the plate umpire, and Hurley walks out towards the mound. And now Hurley and Mongo's head having a little chat out there. And Johnny Pesky, the Red Sox skipper, hangs on his hips with a warm-up jacket on. Talking with Bob Tillman, Mongo Kett picks up the rosin bag, fires it down to the ground. Pete Jordan and Wilbur Woods still loosening up in the bullpen for the Red Sox. Jordan is a right-hand pitcher, Wilbur Wood a left-hander. Pesky walking back now to the Red Sox dugout. And the base is loaded. The infield shortens up a couple of steps. They know Lins can run. The windup by Mambo. His pitch is on the outside corner, strike for one on one. Threw him a slider that time. Doesn't want to give him too fat a pitch. Red Sox scored two in the second, one in the third. The Yankees scored their two runs in the third inning. First, Howard at second, Pepitone at third, lead away. The pitch is a ground ball to third. Now thrown up, and it steps on third base. Throws to first, double play. And the Red Sox get out of the inning. For the Yankees, in the bottom of the fourth inning, no runs, one hit, no Red Sox errors, two men left, and at the end of four full innings, it's the Red Sox 3 and the Yankees 2. Top of the fifth inning, Eddie Brasseau will lead off. Brasseau bounced to first and beat out an infield single. He has scored a run. Whitey Ford ready. His pitch is inside, ball one. Starts in, moves back under it now, and makes the catch. One away, brings up Carl Yastrzemski. Yastrzemski struck out and hit back to the box. Bag at third, left hitting his Yastrzemski up there, takes the strike on the inside corner. Whitey's curve is hit right back to the box. Ford is up with it, wheels around, throws to Pepitone, that's two away. Slice that Yastrzemski is hit back to the box. And it brings up Frank Malzone. Malzone has walked, single to center, has driven in a run and scored a run. Born right here in the Bronx in New York City. Whitey takes his hit high in the air to short right center field. Puts in trouble. And it's going to drop in for a base hit. Now Jones trying to shoot. Battle cannot get the ball. That ball hit in the ground and stuck. Half buried itself, and Mickey was trying to pick it up. And now Jones hustling all the way, goes in the second with a stand-up double. I mean to tell you, that is treacherous footing out in that outfield. Base hits that dropped in short right field earlier in the ball game for the Red Sox. That would have been caught easily under normal playing conditions, but that ball hit and buried. Boy, you couldn't hit a wedge to the green better than that. I don't care if you're Arnold Palmer, Jack Nicklaus, Joe Cooper, or Bill King. Here's Dick Stewart. He singled a center and struck out. Two out. Now Zona is at second. By Whitey. Pitch It's to Stewart. It's broken back, ground ball is short. Lenz is up with it, throws to first in time for the out. And three parts of that bat went in different directions.
Boy is picking up two parts of it right now. That really broke.
For the Red Sox in the top of the fifth, no runs, one hit, no Yankee errors, one man left. And at the end of four and a half, the Red Sox three, the Yankees two. In the top of the fifth inning, Eddie Brasseau will lead off. Brasseau bounced to first and beat out an infield single. He has scored a run. Whitey Ford ready. His pitch is inside, ball one. Yastrzemski struck out and hit back to the box. Boyer, even with the bag at third, left hitting Yastrzemski up there, takes a strike on the inside corner. Back to the box. Ford is up with it. Wheels around. Goes to Pepitone. That's two away. Twice that distance. He is hit back to the box. And it brings up Frank Maljone. Maljone has walked single to center, has driven in a run and scored a run. Maljone, born right here in the Bronx in New York City. Whitey's pitch is hit high in the air to short right center field. Could be trouble. And it's going to drop in for a base hit. Now Jones trying to shoot down. It cannot get the ball. That ball hit in the ground and stuck. Half buried itself. And Mickey was trying to pick it up. And now Jones hustling all the way. Goes in a second with a stand-up double. I mean to tell you, that is treacherous footing out in that outfield. That dropped in short right field earlier in the ball game for the Red Sox. That would have been caught easily under normal playing conditions, but that ball hit and buried. Boy, you couldn't hit a wedge to the green better than that. I don't care if you're Arnold Palmer, Jack Nicklaus, Joe Cooper, or Bill King. Here's Dick Stewart. He singled the center and struck out. Two out. Now Jones is at second. Whitey. Pitch to Stewart. It's broken back, ground ball is short. Lenz is up with it. Throws to first in time for the out. And three parts of that bat went in different directions. Boy is picking up two parts of it right now. That really broke. For the Red Sox in the top of the fifth, no runs, one hit, no Yankee errors, one man left. And at the end of four and a half, the Red Sox three, the Yankees two. Pause for station identification.
This is WOKO, Albany, New York, your Yankee station. Yankee games at night and day at home and away on 1460 radio. The time is 3:31.
Bobby Richardson, line to left field, singled off Maljone's glove, is driven in a run, leads off, takes the curve right in there, strike one call. Bobby was leaning away from that breaking pitch. It broke right over the plate. Beautiful day for the ball game, just a little nip in the air. Reminds me of World Series weather. Fastball hit in the ground is short, but Stewart to his left has it. Throws to Stewart, it's one out. Brings up Roger Maris. Maris single to center and fly to center field. Roger had the first Yankee base hit of his 1964 season. The first inning was two outs. Against Maris.
other game scheduled in the American League. Cincinnati's outside. In the National League, Cincinnati at Los Angeles, Milwaukee at Houston, both night games, and St. Louis at San Francisco, an afternoon game starts later on. The only other game scheduled in the National League. Pitch, a high pop-up to the left side. Frank Maldon at third base is under it in fair territory. Takes it for the second out. Two in, it brings up Mickey Mantle. Mickey flying to center, single to right. Mickey is driven in a run. On deck, Tom Trett. He'll be followed by Tony Conigliaro and Bob Tillman. Now Ed Hurley talking with Whitey Ford. I believe they're waiting for the light to be put on. At least Ed Hurley made a motion up towards the light. Talking with Lou Clinton right now. And now they're going on. The lights are going on at Yankee Stadium at 3:37 p.m. in the afternoon. All right, now we're ready to go. Whitey's first pitch is low, ball one. Quite a few shadows around home plate and just now reaching the pitching box. And now Lou Clinton wants to look at that ball. Whitey flips it into Howard. Ed Haley's taking a look at it. He's going to throw it out of play. Well, with the lights turned on, Clinton saw something on the ball that shouldn't have been there. He rubs up the new ball. One nothing pitch is outside. Two balls, no strike. Two nothing pitch. The ground ball hits it short. Lane comes in. He has it. Throws to Pepitone. One out. brings up Tony Conigliaro, hit into a double play in the second inning, bounced to third in the fourth inning. Youngster is tall and slender. They say he looks a lot in gear like Joe DiMaggio did when he first came up. He lines his team a little up there. Well, he sure hit that one like DiMaggio, I'll tell you. Fastball, he hit a bullet in the left field. His first major league hit. Line single left, the eighth hit for the Red Sox off Whitey Four. Brings up Bob Tillman, who is two for two, single to right and single to center. Tillman has driven in one run. Takes the Tillman, slow ground ball down to third baseline. Gonna be trouble. Boyle picks it up, throws the first, not in time. That's an infield single. Playing deep on Tillman, who is not fast and can hit the ball hard, was fooled as Tillman hit one right off the end of his bat, a slow roller that died on the slow grass. And now the Red Sox have runners at first and second with one out. And the batter will be Bill Mambuchet, who walked and struck out. 9 hits now for the Red Sox. They lead 3-2 here in the top of the sixth. Pepitone moves in at first, boy, even with a bag at third. That's just killing. Strike by Whitey. Hit, Mumbo, ready to hit, takes it outside, ball one. He bluffed him up, and Pepitone came charging in, was ready to swing away, but the pitch was high and outside. Whitey stretches. Hit the ground ball, hit off the plate for foul to the right. Pepitone in, picks it up. Back to second, Tillman back to first. Whitey goes to the rosin bag. That's by Whitey.
Ground ball swings to his left up, but it steps on second. Throws the first double play. Ball hit perfectly for Bill Lynn to make the double play. Only going to take one step. Four to Red Sox in the top of the sixth. No runs. Two hits, no Yankee errors, one man left, and a game of 5.5. The Red Sox, 3 and the Yankees, 2.
Double time. It's double time. Double time.
Let's try for you.
Double time. And time. And nothing left for you.
The best tobacco makes the best smoke. The exclusive Camel blend of choice quality tobaccos has never been equaled. For clean-cut taste, honest enjoyment, easy-going mildness, the best tobacco makes the best smoke.
Inning, John Trish will lead off for the Yankees. Trish was robbed of an extra base hit on a beautiful play by the rookie, Tony Conigliaro, in center field for the Red Sox as he leaps high against the right center field wall, catching a long drive from Trish. Beautifully timed play. He'll be followed by Joe Pepitone and Elson Howard. Tomorrow, the Yankees go to Baltimore to open the season down there for the Orioles. And it'll be Jim Bowden going for the Yankees against Steve Barber, the left-hander from Baltimore. Here at Yankee Stadium in the bottom of the sixth, the Red Sox lead 3-2. First pitch to Trish. Low bunt. He stops the eagle out of the slow curve. He stops the run up and bunt takes it. Never heard of a slow bunt. Tom Trish. It's high in the air to left center field. Conigliaro and Yastrzemski there. Yastrzemski falls and he's got it. Yastrzemski went a long way for that ball.
Brings up Pepitone. Joe fouled at the catcher in the second, and he walks in the fourth inning. In the fourth inning, the Yankees have the bases loaded with only one out. But then Mumbo got Lynn to hit to Mal Jones and turned it into a double play. Mr. Pepitone swing and a missed strike one, and Joe had a good cut at that one. Now back into the batter's box. One strike pitch, the ground ball to first base. Backhanded by Dick Stewart. Close to Mambo Cat in time for the out. A beautiful play by Dick Stewart. He's not noted for his exceptional fielding, but he made that one look easy. Hit ground ball to his right. Two away. And here's Elston Howard. Ellie struck out and single right center field. Ellie received the Most Valuable Player award prior to today's game. Pitch to Howard. The curve hits slowly down the third baseline. Now drawn in. Bare hands across the first. Sixth, and the score now at the end of six full innings. The Red Sox 3 and the Yankees 2.
Right now, I'd like to say that the next portion of this game will be brought to you by Ballantine Beer. Beer after beer, the most refreshing around. So smile, settle back, and enjoy baseball and ice-cold Ballantine Beer.
Thank you very much, Bill.
Hello there, everybody.
Those of you didn't get the scores of last night's game, I don't know whether any of the boys gave them previously or not. In the American League, Washington defeated the Angels 6-4 in the only game played. While in the National League, San Francisco went 10 innings to beat Milwaukee 10-8, while the Cardinals defeated Los Angeles 6-2 last night. Even their series at the Kofax has got them out in the opening. Pittsburgh in 12 innings beats the Cubs 5-4, and Philadelphia beats the Mets 4-1. Today, in the American League, Baltimore 4, Chicago 2, at the end of 5 innings, McNally and Herbert. Orsino homered with one arm in the fifth for Baltimore, Hanson in the second for Chicago, Minnesota, Washington, right game on the game schedule. In the National League, Cincinnati, Los Angeles, Milwaukee, Houston, night game. St. Louis of San Francisco, it'll be Simmons and Henley, the only game scheduled. As we play in the seventh inning here at Yankee Stadium, Chuck Gilling takes a strike, and the count is 1-2 on him. I wanted to get those scores in for you. 3-2 favor the Red Sox, seventh inning. Inside the next pitch, and the count is 2-2. He hits to all fields, something that you can judge for yourself when you come to the game. Just watch the position for the outfielders. The pitch swung on and missed. Right there. One away in the seventh inning. Red Sox leading 3-2. Ed Brisseau grounded out to first, made out an infield roller to third, and fly to left. Yastrzemski's on deck. Forward end with the windup. Around comes the left arm. The pitch swung on and missed. Strike one. Brisseau looks back at him as if to say, what in the world is that you threw to me? And now the pitch to the right-hand hitter. Brisseau swings and lines it out in the right field. Maris chasing it. Doubles to right center. on deck.
Four to the stretch, and the pitch is inside. Ball one. Boston 3, New York 2, seventh inning. Board all set, and the pitch. Swung on a ground ball, hits the second. Richardson up with it, throws easily on a pepper cone. Up comes Frank Malzone, who walked, single to center, and doubled to center, drove in a run.
Jack Padden, who got out there to check. So with the ace in the hole, gonna be the buzzer, Dick Rabbit. Gonna try throwing a couple of pitches. Just to see where, I don't know whether he pulled a leg muscle or what. Phil Lynn has the pleasure of being the first batter to face Dick Raddick. One out and the pitch. It's a hummer in there, strike one. Next pitch, swung on and missed. Strike two. Lynn flying to right, grounded to second, and grounded to third. And the pitch, swung on as a high fly ball and left. Now coming in and making the catch is Yastrzemski. Started way back, and Lynn blew it in. And here's Bobby Richardson. Slide to left. Had an infield hit to third and grounded to short. Two outs now in the seventh inning. Into the stretch and the pitch. Swung on and popped up. Dick Stewart comes in, makes the catch near the mound. And the side is retired. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left on. And at the end of seven innings, Boston, 3 runs, 10 hits, no errors. The Yankees, 2 runs, 6 hits, and no errors. Now in the eighth inning, Dick Stewart swings at the first pitch and hits it down the first baseline for a strike. Stewart singled to center, took a third strike, and grounded to short. Stewart hit .382 against the Yankees last year. Drove in 18 runs and had 5 homers. Bill Kane has been doing his homework during the winter. Now the pitch swung on a slow roller that Boyle had to hurry on the throw in time. One away. Now coming up is Luke Clinton. Single, flying to left and grounded to short. In there, strike one. Whitey's next delivery. High, ball one, one and one. The 1-1 offering. Swung on and lined into the gap in left center. Drake has to hurry. He one-hands her and throws it in to Clinton to a single. Remember, friends, that this year we're going to have 6 suburbanite games. An innovation which we hope you'll cotton to. Man, I love those cotton chicken Texas frog games. An first pitch down the third baseline for strike. Young man playing his first major league game. 1-for-3. Fourth pitch is swung on and hit in the air in right field.
fade away from first and second. Two strike pitch. Look out. That's three. He swung at a pitch that almost hit him. They are right in at the letter. Now up comes Cleet Poyer. Single to center, fly to right, single to right. Here's the pitch, and it's low and inside. 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Now the 2-2 delivery. Swung on and missed. Strike three. One away in the ninth. Chuck Schilling, the leadoff man, grounded to short, fly to left, grounded to short, and struck out. Ford's delivery. Swung on and fouled back. Strike one. Who's got that, Ralph out? Man sitting next to him. Bruised his pitching elbow when he fell, and trainer Jack Fadden says he's not serious. Here's the pitch on the way. Swung on and fouled off upstairs. A two-strike count. Starting to get a little tired. on ground is foul down the third baseline.
Let you down. Opposite
count and two outs. Throws over to first, and he throws the ball away.
Swings and misses. Strike one. Stewart
third strike, grounded to short, grounded to third. Ford into the windup, and the pitch swung on. There's a high drive to deep right. Maris swung all the way back to the barrier, and one hand shot right at the barrier. That wind is blowing out toward right and giving them a little trouble. Two down, and up comes Clinton. Swung on, and there's another high fly ball to right. Maris is under it, and has it. No runs, no hits, no errors, no one left on. The end of 9.5 innings. It's 3-3.
A clean new motor gives maximum power and performance. But soon, sludge begins to form, thicken, coating engine parts, feeling power and performance. Today's higher compression engines, plus today's congested traffic conditions, cause more of this damaging sludge than ever before. More than ordinary motor oils can cope with. But now, you can combat engine sludge with new Atlantic Imperial Motor Oil. It keeps more dirt in suspension, helps keep sludge off engine parts, drains out deposits with each oil change. Some of the new highly publicized motor oils you've heard about may claim to perform miracles, yet none of them can protect your engine better. Prove it to yourself with the special introductory offer on new Atlantic Imperial Motor Oil. The first oil so good, Atlantic has given it the Imperial name and feel. WOKO in Albany, New York.
Half of the 10th inning. Mickey Mantle leads off. Fly to center, single to right, grounded to first, fly to left. One run batted in, and one save. Now the pitch, swung on and missed, strike one.
delivery is right in the side to punt it, and there's a curve over. Strike. Two strikes to count. And a two-strike pitch. High outside, ball one. Ball two, 2-2. Last of the 10th. Raddatz delivers pitch, it's foul back. Two strikes. And the pitch. Swung on and missed. Strike three. Three strikeouts in a row for Dick Raddatz. Four altogether. And up comes Joe Pepitone. Foul of the catcher. Walk. Grounded to first and safe on an error. Ball hopping now. And the next one. It's over. Strike two. Strikes on Joe Pepitone. Next pitch is cut on and fouled off out of play. And the next pitch. Sails outside, one and two. Ball, two strikes. Dick Raddatz delivers, and the pitch is swung on and fouled back. Here's the next delivery. Swung on, has a drive through the deep right field, and it's foul. Boy, he conked that one, but it was foul. John Clary gave us the time to pick it in. Two strikes, two outs. Last of the 10th. Three all. Dick Raddatz delivers, and it's high and away. Ball three, 3-2. The payoff pitch. Outside, ball four. Joe Pepitone walks, and up comes Elston Howard.
out Howard in the eighth inning. He blistered him with fastballs that tailed into him. Same time to sail away from the left-hand batter. Ready, it's ready. And the pitch. Swung on, line down the left field line. Clifford's going to turn second. He's on his way to third. And he is out of third on a good throw from Jasinski. Now Zone making his tag. A beautiful pitch up and a perfect strike to third base. The ball never hits the ground. Out of third. No runs, one hit, no errors, and one left on. And at the end of 10 innings of play, Boston, 3 runs, 12 hits, 2 errors. The Yankees, 3 runs, 10 hits, and no errors. Now we're ready for the first half of the 11th inning. And the first pitch is fouled off of the left of the plate by Tony Conigliaro. Conigliaro. And the pitch. Swung on a ground ball, hits it short. Up with it is Lins. He throws in time. That ball can fly down the line, let me tell you. Bob Tillman. Three for four. Single to right and center, and infield hits the third and fly to center. For you late tuners in, here's the pitch right now. Swung on, fouled off. Conigliaro, this 19 from Swampscott. Parents are here watching a game, playing his first major league game. And Gary Geiger's operation, giving him an opportunity he's made the most of. And he almost did into a triple play his first time he was at bat in the major league. Here's the pitch. Dips low outside. But he beats the throw to first. Here's the pitch swung on. There's another high drive to dead center. And running out to the bullpen, Dalton Jones. Pete Charton and Ed Connolly in the bullpen. The stretch by Ford. They'll throw to third base and runners back. Try to pick them off at third. First of the 11. Is outside. Ball one. One ball, no strike. The infield is in, but Boyer and Pepitone particularly loves the pitcher. He's had to look for a bunt. But Williams is a guy that can generally hit a fly ball for you anyway. Now the stretch. And the pitch. It bounces away from Howard. Hits the plate. And Mejia comes on in to score on a wild pitch. So it's 4-3 in favor of the Red Sox. One out and nobody on. Dick Williams up there heading for Raddick. Ford pitched in there for a strike, turn one. Next delivery swung on, grounded to short. Lynn's up with it, throws on the first in time. And they're two away. Infield it backed up. So two down, up comes Chuck Schilling. Grounded to short, fly to left, grounded to short, struck out, head to the box. Whitey Ford has been in there all the way. End of the windup, the pitch. Inside, ball one. Next pitch swung on, hit to short. Glenn's up with it, throws to Pepitone in time. The time's retired. One run, one hit, no errors, no one left on, and a 10.5 inning. Boston 4, New York 3.
Your home of champions station in the Capital District, WOKO, 1460 radio. 3 minutes past 5.
For the Red Sox, as we come into the last of the 11th, Bob Hefner and Russ Nixon. Cleet Boyer at bat, the pitch, swung on and missed, strike one. The lanky right-hander into the windup, and the pitch, swung on and missed, good curve, strike two. And the pitch, swung on and missed. Strike three. He can throw pretty hard. Johnny Blanchard batting for Ford. Shift on John. Here's the delivery. Swung on and missed. Strike one. And the next pitch. Outside. Ball one. One and one. One one out in the last of the 11th. Baltimore defeated Chicago 4-3. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed. Track two. Cards lead the Giants 2-0 and 4. Fountain and Barber tomorrow afternoon in Baltimore. The 1-2 pitch. Low and inside, 2-2. That ball moving around. Two balls, two strikes. And the pitch. It bounces away from the catcher. Ball three. 3-2. Pitch on the way to Blanchard. Swung on. There's the drive, but it's going to be foul in the right field stand. That's two Yankees hit in the last two innings that were foul. 3-2 pitch again. Swung on and missed. Strike three. Threw him a curveball, and it was inside. He went after it. Wanted to hold the bat back, but couldn't. Comes Phil in. Slide to right, grounded to second. Grounded to third into a double play. Slide to left and beat out of front. Two down in the last of the 11. Bob Hefner in relief of Raddick. Into the windup, the pitch. Low, ball one. He's got a pretty good curve. Fast curve. Looks a little like a sinker. And the next pitch. It's accidentally swung on. Strike one. Lins is back in the pitch. A 1-1 count. Swung on and pop foul up there. Last year, the Yankees won the opening game. It was in Kansas City, 8-2. Here's the 1-2 pitch. A ground ball hits the short. The throw on over to first in time. Left on. And the Red Sox defeat the Yankees in the season's opener by a score of 4-3. Boston, 4 runs, 13 hits, 2 errors. And 9 men left on base. Yankees, 3 runs, 10 hits, no errors, 10 men left on. Whitey Ford, seeking his 200th victory, instead lost his 79th game. The winning pitcher was Dick Raddick.